Hey everyone, Ben here and welcome back to the channel. We are in the first round proper of the TCR eSports competition. TCR Virtual ran on simracing.gp and we have qualified. We got through the Nürburgring round. We're here at Laguna Seca. We've got one shot at getting through to the next round. In order to get there, we've got to finish in the top 10 of this race. Luckily, we've qualified in 10th. So really, it's going to be about holding on to that position, trying to be opportunistic and making a bit of progress as we go, if we can. And we are underway already. It's a 15-minute race, sprint to the finish line, and we're down then the start-finish straight for the first time, just trying to pick our spot on the track to get through T1 safely. The worst thing that we could do at this point in the race is anything too optimistic or ambitious and end up at the back of the pack. So we just get a nudge there as we're coming around the corner, but we just about keep it in a straight line. We've retained 10th position despite the fact that cars were jostling right, left and center. We've got one car off to the left there. It looked like a Cupra. He's going to be running slow as he rejoins. The two cars up ahead of us come together and we're going to sneak down the inside of the Cupra, who's going to have to tuck in behind us as we come to the halfway point of this opening lap. We shape to defend on the inside, get a big nudge from behind there as we come through the left-hander, and he is now positioned, if you look at the helicourser, to make a pass into the next corner. I'm going to let him go. I'm not going to seek to defend this one because, frankly, we don't need to get taken out of this race. That has compromised us a little against the Alfa Romeo of Owen behind us, but we're going to hold the position as we come up to the corkscrew for the first time. Tricky braking zone. These cars want to pull you around into a spin if you get on the brakes too heavy, but thankfully, we get through there in one piece on this opening lap, and we're back down into 10th place. I'm not going to lie to you, it's quite intense being in this competition format where you know that one mistake means you could be out of the running completely. Down into the final corner then, into first gear, swing the car through and onto the start-finish straight to end lap one, which I've got to say has gone about as well as I imagined that it would. There's a tightly packed group of cars just up ahead of us. Three cars really look like they're going to be vying for position as we go into T1 again, and the Link car's got it wrong. That's going to allow the Cupra through, and yes, he's made that move stick. We get through just about safely ourselves behind, and I'm just going to try and play a bit of a waiting game here. I don't want to rush anything, and I'm going to really have a look at what's going on in my rear view mirror at the same time as what's going on up ahead, because if we can hold 10th place, then that's all we need from this race. A quick word on the mod. So this is of course the official TCR pack that we're running, and I wasn't sort of bowled over by it in the qualifying heats, it's fair to say. I think it sort of did a job, but compared to other touring car content that I've played on, say Race Room, or even some other mod packages, it didn't feel amazing, but the guys have worked on it a lot and it does show. This feels much more like the kind of touring car experience you may be used to from other sims. Easier to get off throttle, oversteer, to swing the car into corners. Still, I think some work that could be done, not perfect, but definitely a step in the right direction. We come then to the end of this second lap, and you can see up ahead there are three cars fighting for position ahead of the Link. So we've got to keep our eyes peeled here as to what's going on around us, because it would only take an accident from one of those guys for us to potentially get caught up in something that we really don't need to at this point. Down then into the braking zone again, we take the apex slightly early. That's going to put us on a slightly awkward line coming out the corner, but we managed to recover it by just feathering the throttle slightly. We've got about a second gap back to Owen in 11th place, and it's really just going to be about holding station for the time being. If an opportunity comes, we'll try and squeeze our way past, but if not, then I'm very happy coming home in this position. The reason why we need to finish in the top 10, it's the top 50% of registered drivers that we need to finish in. There were 20 registered drivers for the session, only 16 made the grid, so we are in a slightly fortunate position in that there are fewer drivers in this field for us to compete with in this opening round. Coming up the hill once more then into the corkscrew. And there's a yellow flag out. It looks like there's been a bit of contact up ahead. Two cars coming together. Another yellow flag flash there. And look at this. This is going to get a little bit tasty coming into the downhill left-hander. The link car's making a move. There's contact. And he's sideways. And we're going to have to try and get around him. And wow, that was so, so close. That is exactly the sort of thing I was talking about that we must try and avoid. And we got away with that by the narrowest of margins. That will promote us up into ninth place, but it could have been the end of our competition. We'll take another look at it once we see a few highlights from the early phase of this race. This is the start then. You can see just how tightly packed the track is here at Laguna Seca. We try and spot our way around the outside of the corner. That brings us into just a tiny bit of contact here with another car that nearly spears them off. I don't think we veered from our line, so I'm not too sure there was much we could do differently there, but you can see the impact of it on the side of our car. There's the Cooper up ahead rejoining. He's going to be running slow through this part of the track, but clearly he has decent pace. He qualified a good number of positions up ahead of us, and he was not messing about. He wanted to get back past and up the grid as quickly as he could. Big tap from behind there, as he really underestimated the extent to which we would have to slow down for the link car up ahead. And then he wants to get down our inside here. There's not room for two cars to safely go through that corner, so we cede the position rather than risk getting taken out. Here's then the big scary moment a few laps into this race. We're following the link car through, and he's trying to take advantage of the two cars up ahead fighting, but they come together. That sends him into a half spin, and we have to just judge which side of the car to try and get around. Mercifully, we pick right. We go to the outside, the opposite direction to which he was spinning in, and we just squeeze our way past as he rejoins two spots down. We rejoin the live action then. We've got about 8 minutes of this race left. We're running in ninth, and we've got Owen behind us still, who's beginning to put on a little bit of pressure. So we have to be mindful. The gap up to eighth is around 2 seconds, so that is looking a bit more challenging to try and reel that in. So at this stage of the race, at least, it's a defensive drive. I'm just trying to not make any mistakes, spot all of our apexes, close off the inside line. Don't give Owen an incentive or an encouragement to try and stick one down the inside into any of these corners. I just want to make sure that we are able to hold this position, because we've got a bit of an insurance buffer now. But look at that. Actually, speaking of which, there's a car gone off up ahead, and that's a Hyundai, and he's dropped behind us. There must have been a big accident up ahead there. We just about make the next corner as I was slightly distracted by what just happened. I was not expecting that at all at this point of the race, but it looks like we've gotten another position, so we'll be up into 8th place as Owen gets a big slide in our rear view mirror behind. Thankfully, doesn't come anywhere near us, but that has given us a bit more breathing space behind. A yellow flag is out as well. Perhaps there's something at the corkscrew here, but if there was, it looks like it's been cleaned up by the time we get there. The pack of cars behind us is fighting hard, though. You can see that in our rearview mirror. This is good stuff for us. It's giving us a little bit of breathing space to the pack behind, and now we have at least a couple of seconds to the cars in our rearview mirror. So we do now have a little bit more comfort to just see through the second half of this race, and we're up into 8th position, so we've got a 2-spot buffer back to the qualification threshold. Here's what happened to the Hyundai then, as he comes round the right-hander. He's going to get up on the curb, and look at that. It looks like one of the rear tyres just bites into the little ditch next to the curb. That pings him into the wall. We are able to shuffle past along with the two cars following us. But look at that, the link car tries to get down his inside. They come together, but they both survive the contact. We fast forward then with just 3 minutes left of this round one heat, and the car up ahead gets it all kinds of wrong into the corkscrew. That's going to give us a chance, I think, to get onto his rear wing as we come into the final stages of this race. We've dropped the cars behind. Owen is now 4 seconds behind us, so we are looking good to get through this opening round and into round two of the eSports competition. Heavy on the brakes here. We're going to close right in on the Cupra up ahead of Amar, and try and mount a final overtake of this race and get up into 7th position. Across the start-finish line then, once again, we're going to try and put a little bit of pressure on into T1. But again, really, I'm not looking to do anything daft here. If we had to get into the top seven in order to qualify, then I would obviously be more racy. But we are in a comfortable qualifying spot here for the next round. So now that the gap has extended a little bit, it feels like the immediate opportunity to get past has perhaps just receded a little bit. And therefore, I'm actually now thinking, having got to the end of the last lap, thinking, yes, come on, let's get past him. Maybe it would be more prudent to just follow Amar home. And not do anything too risky towards the end of this race. And you never know, if he makes another mistake, then, you know, brilliant, let's try and capitalise on it. But let's not do anything too daft with just 1.5 minutes left on the race clock. On the brakes again then, into the corkscrew, get the car turned in. We are closing up in that braking zone every lap, but not really enough to make a move. And to be honest, who wants to make a move at this stage down into the corkscrew anyway? Little yellow flag pops up, that must be behind us because we hadn't seen anything. Oh, but look at that, we get a big tank slapper on coming through the right-hander. That's how small the margins are. We could have thrown away our position on track there had we just not saved that slide. So it was really at that point that I thought, yeah, the fight, let's call it off. We're not going to try and push for position here. We're just going to moderate our pace. And in the end, Owen ended up squeezing up just a little bit onto us from behind there. You can see the gap comes down by a couple of seconds. We let Amar go up ahead. And we are going to come home in a really solid eighth place. We've done the job that we needed to. We're going to qualify for round two of the TCR Virtual eSports at simracing.gp. I'm really happy with that. That puts us through to the next round at the Red Bull Ring. The servers for which are live now, this week, as this video goes live, so we'll be racing on that later on this week. Here's the final classifications. A really solid, enjoyable race. The mod is getting better. Looking forward to the Red Bull Ring in round two. I have no idea how far we can go in this competition, but we're going to see what we can do. I don't think we're ever going to have the pace of the front runners, so sooner or later, we're going to be found out. But I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, leave a like, get subscribed, and I'll see you on the next one.